All right, welcome back. And in the last episode, we were just making sure everything was good to go. So we've got our node, we've got the basic town, we've got our trader here. So let's give him something to trade. Alloy for firewood. Okay. Let's throw 1,000 in there. I'm just going to throw 1,000 fish in as well, because we're going to have an abundance of that. So I'll take this down to 1 so I can manage it more easily in my professions tab. Bom, 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 bom. Okay, so let him crack on there. Now we've got 7 people in total. I wouldn't mind putting another woodsman in, just because we're going to be selling a lot of firewood, so we may as well make sure it's topped up. And also, we're going to be wanting access to this side of the map as well, so we should throw in a bridge. I quite like the drawbridges over the main rivers. And it's a thin one as well, so it'll fit in between these two buildings. Okay, and then we should landscape the trading post a little bit, I think. So let's just take this to the edge. Now, as regards the stockpiles, we don't need them as big as I would normally have them, because we've got the slightly ridiculous storage mod. And until later in the game, this won't even get filled up. So we'll put a standard storage in, and let's put material storage in as well, because we're going to be producing quite a lot of materials. Let's just draw a road around there, and we're going to need some storage barns. So stick to the tried and trusted. I like these because you can upgrade them and get even more in there, and they look quite nice when they're upgraded as well. I think better than this model here. So throw one there, throw one there. Bit of colouring in. Yeah, why is this on pause? Let's get this off pause. We're getting building. Okay. So it's all looking good so far. Let's just try to see what I'm doing here. Let's clear a bit of this away. Now, for nomads, we want nomads really. They help for a number of reasons. The deaths in the game sometimes come all at once, and so one minute you might find yourself loads of people coming out of school, and then the next minute they're all dead. So it sort of peaks and troughs really. So if we can get nomads coming in, then we can obviously use those to counterbalance those times. And obviously for nomads we need trading posts. What else do we need? We need a town hall, and we need a market square. Always advisable to have a hospital and boarding house knocking about somewhere as well, in case they bring in disease and such. So let's put a town hall in, and then it gives us access to the stats as well. Okay, town hall. So let's just extend that bit of road. Let's see what we're doing. Get things lined up correctly. Okay. Yeah, so we've got a gap on each side. And we've got a road on the back. I don't want any more than that. Yeah, I might just take it out one more. I'll just give a bit of greenery. A bit of green space around it. town hall on the way. Now I think we're going to need a market, so let's have a look what we've got. We have a few different markets available with the mods that we've put in. So we've got this hardware store, which looks like a winery or brewery or something that's been repurposed. A general store, which I think is pretty funky. Definitely a more unusual model. We'll definitely be using that later on. And a tiny little farm stand, but you can see the area. It's not too bad. Obviously smaller than the rest, but good for outlying villages or settlements, that type of thing. But at the moment, we're just going to stick with a rural market. I don't think we're ready for a town market just yet. Okay. So, where are we going to put this? I need to put that there. There. I mean, yeah. Let's put it there just so it lines up with this little gap here. And then and we'll just fill this around. There we go. Excuse me. Okay. Right. How are we getting on? Let's prioritize. Keep all our guys on point. Let's get these built. I'm going to pause the rural market and the town hall just for a second. And I'm going to push for these two to get done. Because I may get rid of this. I'm not sure yet. We might actually get rid of that. Okay, here we go. Because I wonder what grave these straight away. Because it's annoying when you forget and then they end up filling up and you've got to wait ages for them to be emptied again. So, well, we've got a few people. Let's give them three for the time being. Yeah, let's throw that. Have you noticed the overlays are transparent? It's just another mod that I've added. It sort of gives you an air that you're viewing a larger percent of the screen. I like it. Okay, let's update this one. So yeah, as I said, we're gonna need. Oh, we've got our first trader. Here we go. Let's have a look. What have you got for me? Ambu. Yeah, I'm going to take that just because bamboo can be quite good to grow and have it bundled up for burning. Save your residents from using your precious firewood. So that should be 700 now. 750. Let's trade. Now, this guy's a seed merchant, so we're going to need herbs. Always buy herbs first. It's just, well, you'll see in a minute. Basically, at the moment, we've got one herbalist and we've got 149 herbs. As your population grows, it's going to be harder for this number to grow as well. So we want some herb fields just to bolster this and make sure that everyone's stealth stays healthy. So, herb seeds every visit, dismiss. Okay. So he's nice and can complete. This guy's nearly done. So we'll leave him to crack on there. Let's put a standard boarding house at the top of the market. It actually fit quite nicely, right, just right across the top of the side of the market. So we'll put that there. Am I leaving a double gate? I'm gonna put it one back, because I think if I do take this out, it's a for a spin. This, you can see, we can probably make this a double road as well on each side of the market. So let's bring that down here. We'll just shorten this as well, and then let's put the double road at the top. We'll take this all the way down here, actually. There we go. And it would be wise to have a hospital in, because even if you haven't had any nomads come, you can still get illnesses, diseases, and they can actually happen fairly early on. So it's worthwhile investing in a hospital sooner rather than later. Let's just see if we can. Let's take it back one. Put that there. Let's chuck another trader in. Let's build. Let's get it done. Okay. That's in, and then we're just going to repeat these same steps. Probably put another couple of storage warehouses in there. So let's take that to the edge, that up a bit. We'll get another couple of stockpiles in there, same layout as before, 2x12, and a material stockpile. Yeah. So I do quite like my my villages, my towns to be aesthetically pleasing, fairly symmetrical. Sometimes I'll do them higgledy-piggledies, put things all over the place and just see how it works out, but I sometimes find that I end up just demolishing the swathes of my town and redoing it anyway, so make it look fairly nice to start with, then I should negate having to do that later on. Okay, a couple of storage bars. And some more colouring in. Okay. So our trader's bay is looking pretty good. The only thing we haven't got is houses for these people, so we're going to need some houses. Now our bridge is done. Now a lot of the buildings require bricks, glass, that type of thing, so we could do with getting that going pretty soon. Especially with items around the dock, the quayside houses, you need glass and brick for those, and they'd look quite nice. The city by the trading posts, or anywhere really. So yeah, let's get cracking with that. How are we doing for everything? Stone goods, iron good, wood. Okay. This guy's at least dropping down to one. And then we'll do the same with him. We'll give him 1,000 firewoods and 1,000 fish, because we can't spare them. Okay. Make sure we've got two traders in there. And yeah, let's get a town hall built. Let's undo that. Let's undo the market. It's always harder to click on these markets for some reason. I don't know why. Okay, so tall man is moaning, so let's up the tools to 550. Don't that much, yeah, should be okay. We've been using a lot of stone, but we'll just crack on and see how we get on. Okay, so for bricks and glass, we need shore houses. Which we'll put on this side of the river. It's quite flat, this, so. Or quite straight, I should say, so. Might be able to get a few on in a row. Four, very nice. Okay. Let's redo that. I don't like that. Shore house. Where are we looking? There we go. Okay. I don't really want it to be higher up than this line, but I think. We may have to be, just by one. Two, three, four. Very good. So I just wanted four for clay, four for sand, so we can average out our brick and glass production. We'll stick with the same coloured roads. Okay, right. These guys are going to need some houses, so hold on. Another trader. Nearly missed you. Okay, food is not going to be a concern for the time being. It's nothing specific that we need from here, so you can disappear. And then we'll stick with our new fountain mud, small wooden houses. I think they look really good behind these shore houses, so we'll give these a go. Let's see, just one to the right of the. Yeah, just one to the right of the furthest fence. And just again, to make everything look quite nice and neat. I'm gonna leave one from there. In fact, I'm gonna wait for these to be built first, actually, so I can line them up correctly. Okay, just give me another builder. Okay, so town hall's been built. That's great news. Let's get you pinned up. So, home 13, family 17. So we definitely needed these houses to be built. Quickly split. That will allow us, well, allow our population to grow. Production line, food. Yes, we're okay for food. Not a huge amount in the inventory as yet. So I always find this with the leather. One hunter's just not enough. Yeah, I mean, it's growing slightly, but really you need. You need cows, add a bit of extra leather. Spirits, resource merchant, what else have you got? Okay, so nothing that we need immediately. I Yeah, thinking about cows, maybe we should put a pasture in ready, just in case one of these merchants brings some. That'll help us boost the leather production for the tailor. Okay, where are we looking? I think a standard pasture will do. So the size that we're looking for. We can go with 30. 15 by 30. Let's stick to 10 by 30. That should be enough. And where do we want? Let's just stick that right at the end. Okay, so if a trader brings us some cows, bison or something, we can put them in here, and we can get a bit more leather for the tailor. Okay, I'm not going to bother putting a guy in the market as yet. It's not really required. Everything's been produced in a very similar area. We don't even need any extra storage at the moment because we've got these. These big barns here. I'm going to destroy this, and I'm going to take out the stop barn next to it as well, just so I can landscape that area a little bit more. Okay, we've run out of trees, so I suppose it's time now to crack on with the forester. So let's just stick four in there. I'm going to put a couple of people in the gatherer's hut as well, just to again offer a variation of foods. I'm going to take the hunter up to three. Eventually these will have four in. Obviously not the herbalist because it only holds two, but I'm going to max that out. It's already gone, nice. Okay, let's just core in that line that we missed there. So let's try one of our K's. Barn, see what we can fit in. This is medium barn. And yeah, that'll go in quite nicely, so we'll put that in there. And just make sure it's all neat and tidy. Okay. Let's run this line up straight up to the market. And we'll do the same here. Okay, cooking with gas. So how are we doing? 8 labourers, 4 builders of 28. Okay, let's prioritise these houses, get some more population growth. And then we'll put a few more in. Just behind here. Yeah. Put that one there. Very good, very good. Okay. And just found these 21. So, houses. We need more houses, basically. If we're going to grow the population, we're going to need more houses. So, what other houses have we got available? Yeah, the fountain mark gives us these medium stone houses, again, quite nice models. Three to choose from, one with a half, a semicircular brick wall sort of thing, one that goes around the full length of the house, and one with a wooden fence. So let's try these brick wooden ones. Let's put one there, one of the half ones, it just fits nicely. Also, you can again put a little bit of road in here on the front, just to keep it all nice and neat. Okay. Okay, we've had our first death. Giving birth. Unfortunate. Okay. Yeah, let's buy this clay. Just because we're on a roll with the breaking glass production. Just random numbers in there, 84. Trades. What do we want him to bring for us? Okay, we want. Do we need lane sand? Let's just get some. And some. I'm going to put logs in there as well. I'll explain why in a second. Okay. Right, so. Back here. We need brickworks. So let's get these put in. So we're not going to use these brickworks purely for bricks. We're going to use them to create charcoal so that the fuel refinery doesn't have to use our firewood. And clay as well, okay. Yeah, bring me some. In fact, iron. Just in case we run out, we want to make sure we've got some on deliver. Every visit, off you go. Thank you very much. Okay. Let's just draw some more roads in, just so it helps. It helps to guide me. Clear a bit of this space from the trees so I can see what I'm doing. They're quite nice, these little medium stone houses, don't they? Yeah, I quite like them. Okay, so again, if we want more people, then we're going to need more houses. We may even need another church and such, so. Should maybe put that, think about putting that in. Let's try and finish this off. Okay, so we're going to need fuel refinery. Let's try and bang that in the middle. We'll leave a gap on one side. And the same with the brickworks. I'm just going to. Just because the glassworks is a bit deeper, and the brickworks. So if I want to keep it all level and straight, so I can put maybe another row of houses behind if required, I can do that. Okay, glassworks. So let's see if I can edge this. Yeah, we'll pop you in there. Do the colouring in. And then we're going to need some stockpiles over here, specifically material stockpiles, because pretty much everything we're going to be making over here is going to be materials. 4x5 should be more than enough. Now these aren't going to build, are they, because I've got no sand, so let's just turn these ones off for the time being. And let's just 1, 2, 3, 4. All producing sand, because we need sand for the brickworks. What are we for the glassworks? Sand, yeah, so sand is important to start with. Okay, now let's set this. See, firewood. See, we don't want them using our firewood, we want them using charcoal. So let's set that. Now these will make charcoal as well, so I'm thinking two brickworks banging out the charcoal, one at the back for bricks on the left, and one for glass on the right hand side. Hopefully, it's clipped a bit. Okay, ores and chip piece. No, no food as yet. Food wise, we're doing okay. I'm gonna put another fisherman over here. Just to spread out where we're getting everything from. Fuel, let's take that up to 10,000. That should hopefully rise steadily as we go along. Thinking I should have made this bigger, so I'll get rid of that just to bring it into line here. So I'll move that as well. Now we've got a bit of a gap in the centre of our base camp, so I don't know. Not sure. What about a statue or something? In fact, I've got quite a nice one. Where are you? Yeah, we've got this Monument Angel statue. Just another one of the mods that I've included. That looks quite nice. It fits perfectly, so we'll throw that in. Now, there's this little icon at the end, which is build your own canal. Now, when we get to using RK's canal systems later on, it sort of puts this to shame, really. But although not necessarily useful for creating canals, it is actually quite useful for just for decoration. So let's put a little bit around this statue. So colour in, just to give it a bit of colour, on the roads UI, we've got a few coloured roads here. Again, another mod, I think it's called Coloured Tiles. So, nothing too garish, I think, but just something to make it still real pretty garish, to be honest. But I don't know, let's throw a little bit of orange in there, see what it looks like. And that's what it looks like when it goes down, and then give it a bit of time, and then it'll look a little bit different. But yeah, nice little centerpiece just by the pond. Okay, more traders. Herb seeds, there we go, that's what we want, so. We only have enough. What have we got? And 1,000 fish should be enough. Okay, so. Don't need the herbs anymore. What else are we going to need? Really, the herbs are one of the most important. One of the most important seeds that you can get. So, what else do we want specifically? I mean, we're gonna need a lot of these things, but yeah. For the time being, you know, I'm just gonna go for quince seeds because I do use a lot of the quince trees in my decoration, so it'll be quite handy. Quite good to have some of those. So yeah, okay, you can go. And now we're gonna need a herb garden. So let's put the pasture back in. Let's take you up to the top. Let's put you there. Another row of houses along here. We're going to use some of RK's houses, which are really good. They're triple floored, so you can put one house down and a second floor and a third floor on top. But we're not going to be using that in the base camp, we're just going to be using the small house models. But they look really good. So we'll just put a few along the back here. Can we fit in? 5, 6, okay. It's got 6 houses around the back, and then I love it when the dimensions work out perfectly. Let's take that down. Put that down there. And then let's just throw a few herb gardens in. You can never have too many herbs. Let's do a couple of 10x30s. Actually, saying that, no, let's not do that. Cause let's try. Well, actually, let's see how much space we've got. 12x30. See what this trader's got for us. Flax seeds. Well, we may as well take them because I'm going to try and get all the seeds. So we may as well take them. Okay. Right, how are we doing over here? So let's set these to create charcoal. Get them going. Let's throw a guy in there. We're running out of guys. Okay. Let's change you to clay. Clay. Okay, you know, I'm going to shut off the glassworks for now because we don't really need it just yet. Am I going to do that? No, you know what, I'm going to close these two. And I'm going to open these two up. So we've got two shore houses digging out the clay, two doing the sand. These are going to be offline until we can get some furnace fuel in. And yeah, I'm just going to give a little wood stockpile so they've got something to... somewhere to put the wood. And I'll give a material stockpile to these guys over here. And again with the colouring in. Right, so we've got bricks and glass on the way. We've got space for cows when they come to bolster the tailor. And have we got enough people? Just about seven. Just be a bit cheeky and take these down to one. Couple in. Okay, so they'll start to grow. It'll bolster this number and it'll keep them all healthy and hopefully happy. So yeah, doing all right so far. That's on the go. Base town has now grown somewhat, ready for nomads. We've got herbs on the go. We've got space for cattle. And we've got bricks and glass on the go as well. So I think we'll leave it there until next time, and I shall see you then.